meet with Brian Livingston. He's the running mate of Manny Pacquiao. He's the one who sets the pace when Manny goes running. It's a tough job, but he does it. And just to let you know, this guy can move. Just a couple years ago in the LA Marathon, he was ranked number one, the top American in the race. That running alongside Manny Pacquiao, what's it like for you?
Yeah, it's a thrill. It's a great way to connect. It's a part of training that a lot of people don't always see, but it's really a time for Manny to meditate, get inside of himself, and really kind of test his limits outside of the ring. And to be there to see him do that is definitely a thrill.
Now, not a lot of people caught on to this, but I did. There was a press conference after the recent fight where Manny thanked only two or three people, and you're one of the people he thanked. He's like, thanks, Brian, running Brian, he called you. Tell me about that. What did that mean to you to get thanked by Manny after his recent fight against Margarito?
I was completely elated.
You didn't even know he noticed you.
But Manny has a place for everyone in his heart, and I was just elated, and just to be part of the whole experience, from training with him to being in Dallas with all of Team Pacquiao, it was surreal, but at the same time, just so eye-opening to be part of that atmosphere.
Brian Livingston, tell me the story, how you and Manny Pacquiao met. I started running.
It was very serendipitous. I mean, I was training for a marathon that day and running up the hills, and I see a guy in a Manny Pacquiao tracksuit with a dog on a leash, and I didn't know who it was, and I literally brushed past him and
show
hit him
me
on the
here.
Shoulder.
Give us an example.
It looked like this.
You're lucky he didn't knock you out right there.
He didn't knock me out. And I ran, and when I got to the top of the hill, I looked back and I realized that it was Manny Pacquiao, and I put my fist out in friendship and I said, sorry, Manny. And he said to me, hey, let's go. Let's run to, let's keep running. Let's see what you got. And we ran together to the top of the hill and challenged him that day. And ever since then, he's liked having me at his side, there to push him, there to pace him, and there's just been a kinship in that.
What is the right form for running?
The right form for running, Manny nails it. It's really being able to move off your forefoot and generate force in a forward motion. So right off your forefoot. And Manny has these really powerful calves where he's just able to really drive himself. Whereas most boxers, you kind of see plodding along with the hood on and just kind of down. But Manny is up, posture forward, and really getting his knees spinning right under his body, and that is more efficient, and that just makes him just a lot more effective in the ring.
Now, some fighters I talk to, it's hard for them to run because they say, you nailed it when you said it's meditation, but for them it's like, hey, we're bored. We want to play soccer. We want to do something where basketball.
Right.
What would you tell fighters about running to help them get over that, where it's good for you, you need it, the endurance, it's not boring, there is a way to do it.
Absolutely. Running is a way to really test yourself. I mean, you will face other fighters in the ring, but ultimately, the person that you truly have to face is yourself. And running allows you to do that. It allows you to explore your limits. And one thing that Manny does is he's never complacent, in my experience seeing him train, with his ability. He always wants to test himself, and running is a vehicle for him to explore that. I mean, he knows how to box, no doubt about that.
From Griffith Park in Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach for ESNewsReporting.com, reporting.